This is our switch end step that we're going to use on our printer. Now, the way it works is when it's depressed, it creates a circuit allowing the flow to the signal cable, which then tells the Marlin firmware that it's reached the end of its access. So in order to do this, we have to connect our connector, which is notched. So we slide it in like so, and that's how we connect this end to the sensor. Now, to review, the green wire right here is our signal wire, the black is our ground, and the red is our voltage. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the board. Okay, to connect this switch end stop, once again, let me review the wires for you. The red is your power, black is ground, and green is signal. So as I've spoken about earlier, the top pin is power, the middle pin is ground, and the bottom pin is signal. So to connect it, all you have to do is bring it in, line it up, and there you go. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the board for programming, and then we'll set it up in Marlin. Okay, once again, we're gonna connect it with the serial USB. So we're gonna put the connector in here, and the other end's gonna go into the USB port on the computer, and you'll hear a beep. Okay, we're in the Marlin 1.1.8. We're gonna open up the folder. We're gonna scroll down to the Marlin folder. We're then gonna hit the M button on the keyboard, scroll down to marlin.ino, and we're gonna hit enter. Okay, now we're gonna select the configuration.h tab. We're then going to verify our configuration. Currently, we have the Arduino Mega selected, which is a similar architecture as the Arduino Mega. And we have port 3 that we need to select. So let's double check that. Now we have it selected. So we're going to do a search on Use Xmin. Okay. Now what we have here is the end stops grouping within the configuration.h tab. So we're going to scroll down and see what we have. It looks like we have the 3 end stops for min uncommented, which means that these are the usable ones. If you need to select a max, you just uncomment like so. But in this case, we're not going to worry about it. So what I'm going to do in a moment is I'm actually going to show you how to set this up. So end stop pull-ups, I'm gonna skip for now. Some people may wanna delve deeper into that subject, but for now I'm going to ignore it. What we're interested in is the X underscore min underscore end stop underscore inverting. Currently, it will say that it's actually triggered when it is not. So we're gonna type true for this, and in a moment, I'll show you in Printerface why that is so. But for now, what we're gonna do is compile and upload to the MKS Gen L board. Okay, we're in the Printerface folder, so we're gonna open up printerface.exe. We're going to connect to the board. And then down below, we're going to type M119 and press enter. And what it says right now is that the Xmin is open, the Ymin is triggered, and the Zmin is triggered. This is why I reversed the logic, because it said that it was triggered if we didn't put true. So in a moment, I'm going to actuate the end stop with my finger and show you in Printerface what it looks like when we type M119 again. So here we go. So as you can see, it says the X-Men is now triggered. Now if I release my finger and press M119 again, it says open. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.